Sue McIntosh and heading tonight.
Getting ready to do my first ever live performances, so I'd love you to join me. I'm going to be at Osaka, Nagoya and here at Tokyo Dome, which holds 40,000 people. I'll also be going to England. I'll show you some footage of delinquents. You can see me messing around, rehearsing, trying to perform, all sorts of things. Please join me. When I finish in Japan, I'm going to England doing a road show. Only under 18s are allowed in, and it's free. Mm-hmm. So for me, that's a way of saying thank you to all those fans in England. And it's great to perform for the Japanese too. I was a bit worried that the Japanese audience would be sort of really conservative and disciplined and clap 10 times and put their hands down. Changes that I suggested yesterday. Touring in England was fantastic. The English audiences were great and it was an incredible learning experience for me. At the same time, I've been learning another skill, which is producing, and I find that every bit as challenging in its own way as performing, particularly in Japan, where the language barrier makes everything about 10 times more difficult, but also it was great fun. Right, done. Here I am just getting the schedule ready for today. Each day my manager and I sort out what's going to be done at what time and then deliver the schedules to the dancers and everyone else involved. Trying to get everything that needs to be done in the day done in as little time as possible, leaving time for us to relax and get to see some of the sights around Japan.
Thank you. Saturday night.
As if travelling weren't enough of a blur, we're about to board Japan's famous bullet train, which should be whizzing us to Osaka at 200 kilometres an hour. Last night's show at Nagoya was incredibly exciting, and now we're ready to take on the rest of Japan, Osaka and the Tokyo Dome. So we're all seasoned travellers by now, but even seasoned travellers get a bit confused from time to time. Everybody's here and more or less in one piece, so let's get this show on the road. Once again, I'm with my number one travelling companion. No, not my manager. My trusty portable computer. While I was busy working, the boys thought they'd sneak a little nap. But I soon took care of that one. In the spirit of sneakiness, we arranged a little surprise for Paul, who turned about 81, I think, on this trip. Anyway, he was overcome with our generosity.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Paul, happy birthday to you.
These guys are my dancers, I'll say my dancers. This is Benno. Say hi, Benno.
Hi.
And this is Richard. And Paul.
Hello.
And Kevin down the back there.
Cool, you know.
And we've worked together quite a few times before. What have we done? Top of the Pops and Royal Variety, Children's Royal Variety, and Jim Will Fix It, and
Dancing in the Park,
Wogan.
And
oh, well, lots of things.
And Hong Kong.
Hong Kong, Miss Asia Pacific in Hong Kong. And these guys went to Australia for a holiday.
And
3 days in Sydney, and it rained. I'm trying to tell them it doesn't always rain in Sydney.
It was snowing.
Hey, it always rains in England.
Kylie, it was snowing.
That was wrong.
Yeah, okay. We agree on something.
It was snowing in Australia, down under. I guarantee you.
We had some adventures, but we won't go into those.
No. Dancing takes as much rehearsal as singing does.
You should push me over.
In the studio, we have to do about 3 run-throughs of the complete show, which I find absolutely exhausting because it's mental as well as physical work.
We just carry on doing the same thing we was doing.
But you know what we could do is just... The effect of stillness would be really good.
Yeah.
The first day, we just all stand there really straight.
Yeah.
And then my jacket can come off, then your...
We take our hats off first.
Your hat can come off when my jacket comes off. That can all happen at the same time.
Okay. And then the other boys. It looks like you're giving us the command to do exactly what you want. Right. That's it.
Exactly the way it should be.
Okay.
Achieved, which I'm really glad about, I didn't know if I could do it or not, was to take a step forward mm-hmm. with my image and my music, but at the same time I don't want to ignore the audience I already have. If you move too fast for your audience, mm-hmm. they're going to say, whoa, what happened? We like that music. What are you doing, you know?
Thank you.
Saturday night. See the world.
I love Japanese food.
Could you tell me what kind of Japanese food do you like?
I like sashimi. I like tempura. Mm-hmm. Miso soup.
Can you eat the raw fish?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my. Oh, this guy.
Yeah. Yes, I know. It's,
you not like it?
Yeah. No. Yeah. I don't eat raw fish. Mm.
So I'm going to try to learn to see why. I can't believe it's all happening tonight and they haven't even laid the floors yet. They're still building. It feels like absolute chaos here. They're hammering, sawing, putting up rigging and lights and unloading all kinds of huge camera equipment. All these people here, all this activity, it's just like a little city. Anyway, come on, let me show you how big this place really is. This is used as a sports arena a lot of the time, so the ground's pretty squishy. Producing a show like this is a little bit like piecing a mosaic together, coordinating the music, the choreography, costumes, lighting, making sure the stage is set and the sets are built.
Uh-oh, they've built more. We've got to walk around.
As a producer, I had all of 2 weeks to put this whole show together. And as you can imagine, I was very nervous about doing it for the first time. Pulling it off has given me a tremendous sense of achievement. Now I can understand why people say nothing beats working live, especially in a place like this. So that's it, Midway. Taking you to the sound desk. We just had a sound check, and I just want to check how it went, how the lighting outline is going. Terry, my manager, has been talking to the lighting desk. It's quite difficult with the language barrier. Let's see how we went.
How many people?
There should be about 40,000 people. This whole area will have people standing so they can dance. It's kind of like a disco party. And up here, I can't imagine what it will be like full of people, but there will be people in this whole area. And I'll be a speck on the stage, so it's lucky I'm wearing glitter, I say. This is the famous soundboard, which is the heart of a live performance, especially in an arena this big. They have to hear us after all.
One, two.
30th anniversary of the greatest movie, Beloved Tara.
It's so bad.
Her father's madness and her mother's death. Rhett sees his chance to finally win Scarlett.
Oh, Rhett.
But her heart secretly remains with Ashley Wilkes.
One night you're not turning here.
Panasonic presents the 50th anniversary of Gone with the Wind. Tonight, 8:30 on 7.
Stay with 7 Now for the powerful conclusion to Gone with the Wind. From next Tuesday, you can now enjoy all your favourite characters from Summer Bay in a special one-hour episode. Home and Away at the new time of 7:30 Tuesday nights on 7.
That was good.
I haven't had time to get my necklace on.
Yay.
Yeah.
The straps on the right side.
We're happy, you're happy, Adrian's happy.
You guys happy?
Everybody's happy.
Everybody's happy. Yeah, I'm happy.
I should be so happy.
Happy. I should be so happy in the world.
One of the greatest mysteries of